This is so exciting. I'm over at Commack High School, and this is the Relay for Life. And standing next to me is the lovely Joan de la Prida. Welcome.
Thank you. Thanks for joining us today, Gail.
Oh, this is my honor, and you know, something that's dear to my heart. But today, let's talk about you. I see that we are standing in front of a tent, and I see a sign. Tell me a little bit about that.
Well, Relay for Life, when you join Relay for Life, you create a team, and your team comes together and walks all night for Relay. So our team last year and this year is Team MBB, which my son helped me name while I was going through treatment. Commack this year is their fourth year. They have 82 teams and over 800 participants tonight walking the track from 6 p.m. to 6 a.m.
Joan, I understand there's a tremendous amount of money that's been raised.
Yes.
You yourself, your team has raised how much?
My team has raised $17,015 as of this morning, which brought me to my Sapphire level, over $15,000. But Commack as a community, over $192,000 this year, breaking every previous year's record. We are the strongest Relay for Life community in the, I think they call it the mid- or the Eastern Division? The Eastern Division.
The Eastern Division.
Which is Long Island, Westchester, and New York City.
That's incredible. Tell everybody where the money goes to and why it's so significant for people to keep contributing.
Right. The money goes to, well, Relay for Life has many programs. Obviously, it's research. Some of the programs are people don't have rides to treatment. They have a program where you can get a ride if you have to go for treatment. One of the programs that I actually use, which is why I decided to raise money, is the Look Good, Feel Better program, which, as you know, you don't feel very well, nor do you look good going through treatment. So when I was going through what I went through, I learned how to wear a wig, wash a wig, put on makeup, and I actually went to this organization for help. That is why I relay. I relay to help other women. It's all via charity. They need fundraising. They need it for research. That's why I relay.
That's phenomenal. And I noticed, too, that there's a tremendous camaraderie here. Every time I meet somebody, they'll say, how many years? You're a survivor.
It's amazing. I mean, my first year was last year. I was very overwhelmed as a survivor. I was honored everywhere I went. I couldn't believe it. Commack as a community truly comes together for this event. It's a very big event for the Commack community.
You were a speaker last year. What was the essential gist of your speech? What would you want people to know?
The gist of my speech was that you don't know until it happens to you. I tell people, you just can't believe it. I run, I jump, I work full time, I exercise, I do everything. I have children. And then I was in bed, bedridden. And then I couldn't come to Relay because I couldn't walk. So I told people that if it happens to you, well, there is a light at the end of the tunnel. It takes time. There's a cure to have hope, but you're going to have to lean on people. You'll see after we do our survivor walk, there'll be a caregiver walk. Without my husband and children, could not have gotten through these treatments.
I love what you said.
The caregivers as well. Tonight's all about the survivors and their families and the caregivers.
I love two things that you just said, that there is a light at the end of the tunnel, there is hope, and that it does take time.
It does take time.
And that you can lean on others. That's a message for all of us.
Right. And it's tough. If you're a full-time working mom like many of us, that is very tough to do.
All right, now you're also a volunteer director. What does that encompass?
As a volunteer director, I got involved this year in planning this entire event, from who is going to provide the showmobile, where are we going to get the tents, how are we going to set up the field, we need security tonight, we need lights, we need the children to be safe. I took an active role in the monthly meetings. We started planning in October, and I took an active role in helping them pull this together.
Well, I want to thank you so much. As a fellow survivor, I applaud you.
Thanks.
And I'm honored to be here. Thank you.
Thank you.
Here with Louis de la Prida. Now, I just spoke with your lovely wife.
You did,
I want to talk to you about being a caretaker, what it encompasses. Your wife said she couldn't have done it without you and your children.
She gives me more credit than I deserve, actually. She did a wonderful job on her own. And my kids and my wife's family really were very, very helpful to us. Joan was actually a very easy patient. She's, if you know her very well, Joan's a very much a type A person. And she was tough. Cancer was not going to get the best of her. And she worked very, very hard to take care of herself and to take care of us.
Well, that's beautiful. What advice would you give to caregivers? Because many times they're also part of the fight against cancer. And sometimes they're forgotten about too.
I would say, you know, reach out to your family and to your friends, and don't try to be so tough. You are going to hurt. I've given an example to people that at different points throughout her illness, I felt as if someone took a bat and hit me over the head with it. My head was just kind of like shaking. I remember going to a breast cancer conference where for the caregivers, and initially I was like, I don't need to go to this. I'm okay. And in fact, I'm not even going to talk. And when the social workers were there and they started asking questions, I was the one that pretty much did all of the talking. And what they said to me was, did you ever think of going to counseling? Did you ever think of talking to somebody about it? And, you know, I had never really thought about it up to that point in time. And I really did. I reached out to family, friends, and some people who were, you know, social workers and psychologists. And they really helped us out a lot. They helped me out personally and also helped me out, helped our family out tremendously.
So one of the themes I'm hearing about tonight is don't be afraid to ask for help. You do need it. You don't realize it at the time. Now, how did people help you?
At this point in time, they help us to by continuing to support the different causes that we support. You were with Joan in the Moms Who Kick. That's a wonderful organization devoted to breast cancer. The Relay for Life is also a wonderful organization. I'm involved with the American Heart Association. There are all these different illnesses that are plaguing society, and I think that we are in a position to help out. Everybody can help out. Even a couple of cents, a couple of hours of your time really go a long way.
Oh, that's terrific. One last question. You do have children. How does one involve the children?
That's been a bit of a challenge because you're never quite sure how much you can say. I think trying not to pretend that there isn't something going on. They're not blind. They can see, especially teenagers. They can see that that mom is suffering, that the family's hurting. And what we decided to do in our particular case was we involved them in the Relay for Life. My daughter is going to be singing the Star Spangled Banner. My son's going to be performing with the band later. And last year they also both performed. So as they've been helping Joan, I think they've been hearing a little bit more about the disease and, recognizing that there is hope, that hopefully there will be a cure and that Joan is going to be okay one way or the other.
Louis, I want to thank you for that and the fact that cancer doesn't just affect that one person. Everyone involved and everyone can do his piece to help. Thank you so much.
You're welcome, Gail. Thank you.
Can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming?
Recognizing this extraordinary, absolutely extraordinary success, we have some very, very special honored guests that will be joining us during our luminaria in a short while. Never before we have flying in today from Texas to come to the only event on all of Long Island because of the success from this community. It has never happened before. However, we would like to share with you that Mr. Steve Zamzow and Lisa Roth, both the national vice presidents of Relay for Life, will be coming in. This is the first time this has ever happened. It is magnificent. It is absolutely, truly a special honor for this community to be recognized for the wonderful work, how we can all pull together and have such a successful Relay.